Hello students, today we are going to cover the second part of the chapter 3 questions. So we have already covered its first part. So before starting the second part, we must remind something of the first part. So what happened up to now? So there was a king and he was having 3 questions in his mind. And he seeked answers of those questions, but he did not get satisfactory answer from many of the wise people. So finally what he did, he went to a widely known hermit to seek the answers of his questions, and then he started digging the ground with that hermit. And then suddenly what they both saw, that there was a running man and he was running towards them. So now we'll see what happened further. So come to the next paragraph, the first paragraph of second part. The king turned round and saw a bearded man running towards them. So what happened? King, he turned his back and he saw that there was a bearded man who was running towards them. Them means the king and the hermit. His hands were pressed against his stomach. So how were his hands? His hands were pressed against his stomach. Why? Because from which blood was flowing. Because his stomach was bleeding. The blood was coming out. Flowing means coming out from the stomach. So he just put his hands against his stomach to stop the flow of the blood. When he reached the king, he fainted and fell to the ground. So when that man, he reached the king, he fainted. Fainted means lost consciousness or to become unconscious. So he fainted there and he fell to the ground. The bearded man became unconscious there and he fell to the ground. The king and the hermit removed the man's clothing and found a large wound in his stomach. So the king and the hermit together, they both removed the man's clothes. And then what they did, what they found? They found a large wound in his stomach. So what is the meaning of wound? Wound is any injury or you can say any cut. So there was a cut in his stomach. So after removing the clothes, they found that there was a cut, there was a wound in his stomach. The king washed and covered it with his handkerchief. So the king washed the wound and he covered the wound with his handkerchief. But the blood would not stop flowing, but the bleeding did not stop. The king redressed the wound until at last the bleeding stopped. Redress the wound means here you can see the meaning of redress is given, dressed again. Redress basically here means to repair the injury. There was the cut in the stomach, so to repair that, the king washed the wound and then he covered it with his handkerchief. But the blood would not stop. The man felt better and asked for something to drink. After that, after some time, the man started feeling better and he asked for something to drink. The king brought fresh water and gave it to him. So what the king did? He brought fresh water and he gave it to the man to drink. By this time, the sun had set and the air was cool. So by this time the sun had set means the night arrived and the air was cool. The king with the hermit's help carried the wounded man into the hut and laid him on the bed. So what the king did? The king with the help of the hermit, he carried the wounded man, that bearded man, into the hut, inside the hut, and laid him on the bed, and he helped him to lie down on the bed. The man closed his eyes and lay quiet. So the man, he closed his eyes and he lay quiet on the bed. The king, tired by his walk and the work he had done, lay down on the floor and slept through the night. So the king was also very much tired by now, because he came to the hermit by walk, and also he had done lot of work with the hermit. He dug the ground with the hermit. So now he was also tired, so he also lay down on the floor and he slept through the night. When he awoke, it was several minutes before he could remember. Several means some minutes. Okay, so when he woke up, what happened? It took some time, it took some minutes before he could remember. Come to the next. Now see, you can see here, there is the king, the hermit and the wounded man. And the king, what he is doing? He is just repairing the wound of the bearded man. Okay, I'll come to the next. So where he was, or who the strange bearded man lying on the bed was. So when the king got, when he got up, when he woke up on the next morning, so it took some time to him to remember what happened last night and who that strange bearded man who was lying on the bed was. "Forgive me," said the bearded man in a weak voice when he saw that the king was awake. So that bearded man, he suddenly started talking to the king, and what he said to the king, "Forgive me. I do not know you and have nothing to forgive you for," said the king. So what the king replied? The king replied that, "I do not know you, and what you have done nothing to me, you have done no wrong to me, then why you are asking for forgiveness? So you do not know me, but I know you. I am that enemy of yours who swore revenge on you." So what that bearded man said to the king? That "you do not know me, but I know you. I am that enemy of yours who swore revenge on you." Swore revenge on you means who wanted to take revenge. Revenge means when you try to hurt someone in return. For example, someone has harmed you and you want to hurt him or her in return. That is known as taking revenge. So that bearded man was the enemy of the king and he wanted to take revenge on the king, because "you put my brother to death and seized my property." And why he was his enemy? Because the king, he killed his brother. Put my brother to death means he killed his brother, the brother of bearded man, and seized my property. And seize means to capture, to take by force. So he also took his property. So that's why that bearded man became his enemy. But the king did not know about this. "I knew you had gone alone to see that hermit, and I made up my mind to kill you on your way home." And then he told further to the king that, "I knew that you are going to the hermit to see him alone, and I was having this plan that when you will return, I will kill you on your way. But the day passed and you did not return. But I was waiting for you, but you did not return. The day also passed, but you did not return. So I left my hiding place and I came upon your bodyguard, who recognized me and wounded me. So what I did, I lost my patience and I left my hiding place where that bearded man was hiding to kill the king. So he left that place and he came upon the king's bodyguard, and the king's bodyguard recognized him and wounded him. means, wounded him means he attacked him. I escaped from him, but I should have died if you have not dressed my wounds. So then he told him further that I escaped from him. Escape means to run away from somewhere. Here it means that he was able to save himself from the bodyguard somehow. But I should have died if you had not dressed my wounds. But then if you had not dressed my wounds, if you had not helped me, then I should have died by now. I wish to kill you and you have saved my life. So he was having the feeling of repentance that he wanted to kill the king. And what the king did with him? He saved his life by repairing his wounds. Now, if I live, I will serve you as your most faithful servant and will order my sons to do the same. Forgive me. So now that bearded man, he said that if I live, if I'm alive now, that is because of you. So I will serve you as your most faithful. Faithful means very loyal or true. So I will serve you throughout my life as your most loyal servant and will order my sons also to do the same. I will order my sons also to become your servant. And then he again asked the king to forgive him. So I hope, students, you are enjoying the story. Now come to the next paragraph. The king was very happy to have made peace with his enemy so easily and to have won him over as a friend. To make peace means to end enmity. Okay. So now what happened? The king was very happy. He was very cheerful. He was feeling good to have made peace. Why he was feeling good? Why he was feeling happy? Because his enmity was ended. And it was ended very easily. He did not do anything great for that. And to have won him over as a friend. And moreover, his enemy became his friend also. So that was really a great thing for the king. So he was very happy. He not only forgave him, but said he would send his servants and his own doctor to look after him. And he promised to give back the man his property. So the king, he forgave the bearded man. And also he said to the bearded man that he would send his servants with him. And also he would send his own doctor with the bearded man to look after him. To look after him means to take care of him. And he also promised, the king also promised to the bearded man to give back his property. Because the king killed the brother of the bearded man and then he captured the property of his brother. So that property he promised to give back to the bearded man. Now come to the next paragraph, students. Leaving the wounded man, the king went out of the hut and looked round for the hermit. Now they both were in the hut, the bearded man and the king. So now what the king did? He left the wounded man in the hut and then he moved outside from the hut and looked round for the hermit and he started searching for the hermit. Before going away, he wished once more to get answers to his questions. So now he knew that the hermit was not going to give the answers of his questions, but still he was having some hope that the hermit may give some answers to his questions. So what he did? The hermit was on his knees sowing seeds in the beds that had been dug the day before. What is the meaning of sowing? Sowing means to spread the seeds over the land so that the plants can grow. So because some hope was there, was left in the king, so he went to the hermit again And then what the hermit was doing? The hermit was sitting and he was sowing the seeds. He was spreading the seeds in the fields over the land, especially in the beds that had been dug the day before. The king went up to the hermit and said, "For the last time, I beg you to answer my questions, wise man." So then the king, he said to the hermit that, "For the last time, I'm begging you, okay, please give the answers of my questions, wise man." Now come to the next paragraph, students. "You have already been answered," said the hermit, still bending down to the ground and looking up at the king as he stood before him. So what the hermit replied? The hermit replied that you have already been answered. You have already got the answers of your questions. Said the hermit, still bending down. He was still sowing the seeds. He was continuing to do his work and he replied to the king. "How have I been answered? What do you mean?" So what he said? The king was very surprised. So he asked the hermit, "How have I been answered? What do you mean? You did not give the answers of any of my questions. Then how can you say that I have already been answered?" So what the hermit said? "Do you not see?" replied the hermit, "if you had not pitied my weakness yesterday and had not dug these beds for me, you would have gone away." Pitied means to feel sympathy for someone, or you can say out of sympathy when you help someone, that is known as pitied. Okay, so the hermit replied to the king that, "Can't you understand? If you had not pitied my weakness like yesterday, if you had not feel sorry for me, for my weakness, and had not dug these beds for me, and if you had not helped me in digging these beds for me, you would have gone away. Then you would have gone away. But what you did? You remained with me and you helped me. Then that man would have attacked you and you would have wished you had stayed with me. And if you would have gone away, what would have happened with you? That hiding man, that bearded man would have attacked you, and at that time you would have wished that you had stayed with me, with the hermit. So the most important time was when you were digging the beds, and I was the most important man, and to do me good was your most important business." So the hermit said, "Now you got the answers of your three questions." So students, do you remember what were the three questions? Okay, let us see again. Okay, just to make you remember. So the three questions were, let's see, if you don't remember the questions, you'll get confused. So these were the three questions. What is the right time to begin something? Which people should he listen to? And what is the most important thing for him to do? Okay, now come back to the same paragraph. So the answers of these questions were, so the most important time was when you were digging the beds and I was the most important man. So the answer for the first question was that the most important time to begin something is that when he was digging the beds and I was the most important man, means hermit was the most important man at that time, and to do me good was your most important business, and at that time to do good for the hermit was the most important task for the king. Afterwards, when the man ran to us, the most important time was when you were caring for him. So then what happened? The man, the bearded man, he came to us. So at that time, the most important time for you was when you were caring for him, because if you had not dressed his wounds, he would have died without having made peace with you. So if you had not taken care of him, he would have died, and your enmity with him may not be ended. So he was the most important man, and what you did for him was your most important business. So at that time, he was the most important man, and what you did for him means you took care of him. That was the most important work for you at that time. So basically what the hermit tried to explain through these two examples, that we have to live in present, and according to the situation, the answers, they get changes, okay? They get changed. So remember, then there is only one time that is important, and that time is now. It is the most important time because it is the only time we have any power to act. So then he explained, the hermit explained, that remember that what is the most important time is now. Now means present. When you are living at present, what you are doing at present, that is the most important time. It is the most important time because it is the only time we have any power to act. Because only in present, like you are, if you are reading this chapter, so what you are doing at this time is the most important thing you are doing, and this is the most important time where you have something, some power to act. The most necessary person is the person you are with at a particular moment, and the most important person in your life is the person with whom you are at a particular moment. So who are the most important person in your life at this time? You are with your parents, so they are the most important people for you. For no one knows what will happen in the future and whether we will meet anyone else, because we do not know that who is going to meet us in the future and who is not going to meet us in the future, and we never know that what is going to happen in the future. The most important business is to do that person good, because we were sent into this world for that purpose alone. And the most important business or the work is to do good to the person who is before you. The person who is with you, the most important work for you is to do good with that person, to behave properly with that person, to take care of that person. So students, what you have understood? Have you understood the answers of those three questions? So what was the first question? Let us remember again. So the first question was, what is the most important time to begin something? So the answer is that the most important time to begin something is present, means now. If you want to start something, you must start in present only. You must not wait for the future. Now the second question was, who is the most important person? So the most important person is the person who is with you right now. At present, the person who is with you, he is the most important person for you. And the third question was, what is the most important work to do in life? What must be the purpose of life? So the answer of this question was that the most important work to do in life is to do good to the others. The person who is living with you or with whom you are spending time, you have to help them. You have to be kind to them, and you have to do good to them. So these are the three answers of those three questions. I hope, students, you have understood very well now. So, and I hope you have understood the story, the whole story, and you have enjoyed it also. And in the next video, we will discuss the comprehension checks, and also we will do the word meanings. So till then, you read this chapter again. So bye bye, take care.